Hey guys, it's Abby here. Let's do a microscope review together. So I'm going to unbox it and we'll go over some of the things that I pulled out. There was a piece of styrofoam in there to help with packaging. And here I have the guidebook, which was pretty thick, and it came with a little CD. Then we have the microscope screen that was packaged in a little soft bag to help keep from scratching the screen. And we have a light shield here, and then I have the remote to control the actual microscope. That's a pretty stretchy remote control, as it's going to be connected to the actual microscope itself. In this bag you get a cord, a USB cord. Then we have the SD card that was in a little plastic container. Then I got this microscope micrometer calibration ruler. I thought that was really cool, so we can measure things very microscopically. Then we have the arm stand for the microscope. And the last thing in the box was the base to the microscope with the two lights on it. Now here's the content package. This was really cool. It shows you what languages you need to look at depending on where you are in the book. 1 through 12 was for me because I speak in English, and explained the steps I needed to do. First thing was to put the arm stand onto the base. For me, I found it a lot easier to actually hold it upside down and screw the base onto the arm rather than the arm onto the base. I don't know why that was. Maybe it's because I really needed the arm to stand up straight. It was difficult for me to do that, but I got it in there, and you will too. The second thing we needed to go ahead and do was put the actual microscope into the stand. So we'll see that there's these two screws, and on the end of the screws there's blue rubber tips. So when you screw it into your microscope to hold it, it's not going to bust up your microscope. So I have it in there, and now I'm going to screw my two screws back in tight. Just to hold my microscope so it doesn't flop around when I try to view things or move it. My two screws are back in there. Now the next thing I'm going to do is I want to take off my light lens, and you can keep that on there if you want to. And the way to take it off is you just pull it straight down. There's no screwing lefty, loosey, righty, tighty. Now we're going to have the light shield come on here. Now, you're going to want it to be the lens fanning out, and instead of doing righty-tighty, lefty-loosey again, this in the instruction says to just twist it back and forth, left and right, and I felt a little bit of a click, and then I just pulled down slightly to see if it stuck on, which it did. Now I turned the microscope to the back, and here's where my remote goes. You'll see that the one end fits in, and when I turn it, the other side of it goes into the side. So the pointier input goes on the side, and the square input goes on the bottom of the base. Now again on the side, we're going to put in our little SD card. You'll see that's really easy. It says TIF, so we'll go ahead and stick that in. Now it took me a second to find the power button. I thought originally it was just on the front of the screen. It's actually on the bottom of the screen. So go ahead, push that, hold it for 3 seconds, and it should power on. Now I have a main board under here so I can try to focus my lens. And you'll see there's the gray bumpy roller that you see me moving my finger over. That's the focusing part of the microscope. Now you see that none of my lights are on right now. If I turn around to the back for my gooseneck lights, there's a roller on the back that controls the lights for the gooseneck lights. Now I see here with my microscope screen, I can actually bend it forward and back, which is something I always appreciate. If I'm sitting somewhere trying to do soldering, sometimes I need the screen to move so I can see better, and I appreciate that. So now I'm going into my settings. There's a lot of different settings you can do: exposure, resolution, image quality, which is really nice. There's a lot of different things, and that goes like through the menu. We have date and time. There's a language settings. Again, there was multiple languages in that manual, and you can change the language if you don't speak English. So now up here in the corner, I'm trying to show you, we're taking a video at this moment, and you can see in the middle at the top, it was in red. I've paused it, now it's white. Now I'm going again, we're recording, we see the red dot by the video and the numbers were red, so it's paused again because it's white. I'm figuring it out with going through the manual. When we see the camera, we know it's a picture, right? So here I push that play button, or I'm gonna call it the movie button. So you see here, I'm actually in a video format, but here I can pause it and then start the video again. Now I'm in the camera and I can take a picture. When I change it, now I'm in the video. Here is where I call it the movie button, right? So we can go back and look at all of our different things. I have it the camera now, so I can take a picture. You see the main board's not there, and now the main board is out. But when I went into that movie mode, you could see that I had the main board out, but it was showing everything that I've taken a picture of, the video, etc. I'm showing you this microscopic ruler that we have. We can measure very tiny fuses if I need to try to order something. And now I want to show you how I can turn on the actual light from the microscope. So we saw that the gooseneck lights were from the roller on the back of the base. The side of the microscope is what controls the microscope lamp. So I'm going to show you. I moved the gooseneck lights and I'm rolling it on the side of the microscope, and that the microscope light turns on along with the gooseneck lights. So now I am trying to just find the correct lighting for when I want to work on my projects, trying to find the correct focus. And here I'm just going to show how, if we wanted to try to measure something, I'm just maybe looking around, say I want to get a new fuse, I'm going to maybe try to put that on there and order the correct size so I don't have to go back and forth and try to guess. So I think that's pretty cool. I've never done a review where they sent a microscopic ruler, so that's very neat. If this seems like it's the microscope for you or somebody that you know and you would like to get it for them as a gift, check out the description box below. We have a discount code that you can use. We hope that you enjoyed this video. Happy printing, everybody.